Back to Shades of Radiology. Today we are going to see an interesting case which is the case of the week. This case is contributed by Dr. Surabhi. So let us see. A 68-year-old female presented with chronic bilateral loin pain, and these are the ultrasound images showing left kidney moderate hydroureternephrosis. Even the right kidney also showed hydroureternephrosis, and in the pelvis the urinary bladder shape in the sagittal plane showing there was a beaking of inferior portion or the neck of the urinary bladder. On axial plane, it was normal with few internal echoes. And this is the transperineal ultrasound which was performed, where you can see the herniation of bladder inferiorly as well as the complete inversion of the uterus, which is coming outside the introitus. And even here you can see the urinary bladder neck is getting compressed, and the entire uterus is completely everted, which is nothing but procedentia, that is the complete uterovaginal prolapse. So this is a case of complete uterovaginal prolapse with associated cystocele and causing compression of urinary bladder neck, causing bilateral moderate hydroureternephrosis. So before going to that, the pelvic organ prolapse can be classified based on the compartment involved, that is the anterior compartment, middle or posterior compartments. You can go back and see, refer this RSNA journal, which is an excellent journal which portrayed the different compartments, what are the boundaries and what are the landmarks, that is the pubococcygeal line and the importance of those lines, and grading of the prolapse is also very important. So based on that compartment structures involved with herniation, the names vary, that is the cystocele or the uterine prolapse or the vaginal apex prolapse or the peritoneocele or sigmoidocele or the rectocele with or without intussusception. So this journal is an excellent journal. You can go back and read about this pelvic organ prolapse. And this is another journal. You can see the transperineal ultrasound depiction clearly showing the normal uterus, but in our case the uterus was completely outside and the bladder was seen with narrowing of the bladder neck in our case, whereas this is the normal depiction of the bladder and the uterus and the rectum. This is the transperineal ultrasound anatomy. And this is another image or the case report which was taken, which was similar to our case. This was CT was done in this case. You can refer this obstructive uropathy caused by uterine prolapse. You can see the complete eversion of the uterus down, that is the complete eversion of uterus, that is the complete prolapse is nothing but procedentia bit below the pubococcygeal line. And here you can see the anal canal also is seen below this pubococcygeal line, and there is also a rectocele associated with procedentia with mild cystocele as well. So the take home message is always consider the pelvic organ prolapse in a postmenopausal woman with unexplained unilateral or bilateral hydroureternephrosis. So be careful in evaluating the cause of hydroureternephrosis, which is unexplainable, and try to carefully evaluate the pelvis and transperineal or transvaginal ultrasound for evaluating the cause. Thank you all.